Hey, what's up guys, welcome back. You are watching Pro Tech. From few days we got lots of Android 15 custom ROMs for most popular devices of all OEMs like OnePlus, Samsung, Xiaomi. We reviewed those universal custom ROM builds for all the devices. You can check them from video description. But some devices which didn't got the official Android 15 updates and didn't have any custom ROM support. Don't worry, we're back with the custom ROM Android 15 GSI for all the devices having the ARM64AB partition scheme. If you don't know what is a custom GSI and how to flash them on any device, please watch our old video playlist. Their links are available in the video description. So I got this aosp based custom GSI build. It's booted on my OnePlus 9RT and it should work for any other devices also. Finally, all the Android devices users can at least test how Android 15 looks like on their devices via this video. In this video, we are going to try this build on 9RT. We'll review everything like essential features working for this GSI, which Android 15 features available by default. And finally, we discuss some major bugs of this GSI. Remember, bugs may differ for each devices, so please watch this video till the end. Now without further delay, let's get started. If you are worried about the flashing of GSI build, you can test them on your device using the DSU sideloader, which is the safest way for flashing GSI and using them as a dual boot on your device. So I installed this build on my 9RT and it's booted with this aosp Android logo. Remember, aosp GSI or the custom builds are purely vanilla stock ROMs without much features. Let's check out the about device details of the GSI. Finally, I am checking this newest Android version of Android 15 on my 9RT. Security patches of October 2024, except this, all other things like kernel version and the firmware build date will be same like stock ROM version that you are using on your device, because GSI always boots with the stock kernel in the DSU sideloader. Major questions arises with the GSI build is what's working, because GSI may get lots of bugs because they are not built for the specific devices. But if you check these working essential features, you can see most of them are working perfectly. Surprisingly, all the sensors are also working great. OnePlus Hello Slider and the OK Google Voice Assistant both are working well. Most important functions like safety net got successfully passed in this build. Basic and device integrities are also got successful. Device Play Protect is certified. So in case of safety concern, this GSI build is rock solid and will run all the banking and payment application. But there are some major bugs in the GSI which may vary as per the device that we will discuss in the bugs and the issues timeline of this video. Now let's check out the new testy features of the Android 15 vanilla ice cream. First one is the private space. You will find this in the privacy and security setting of the device. You can set the different lock screen, pin, password for this space if the two different users are using the same device. This private space will be found at the bottom of the app drawer after enabling this feature, which can be accessible only via security codes set by the user. Next is the app pairing. We often use some productivity application with the entertainment applications like YouTube as a split screen. But every time to use this combination, we have to open both the applications separately and then we have to add them in a split screen through the recents panel. But now we got the new option like app pairing for such split screen in the recent shortcuts, which makes available the pair of the application shortcut on the home screen, which can be accessible all the time. Next is the new theft protection feature of Android 15. This feature actually I didn't got in a stable Android 15 custom ROMs, which I reviewed a few days ago. This security offers the theft detection lock along with the offline device locks. also get remote lock option to manually lock your device if it's got stolen. Even you can find and erase the device data. This is a surprisingly very useful feature to protect your personal data if the device got stolen by the thieves. Next, you can now resize the wallpapers before applying them on the home screen through the wallpapers and style setting. Also get a small preview of wallpapers for home screen and the lock screen. We got this new styler expanded volume panel in the Android 15, which offers almost all the settings of the stock sound control. We got this new screensaver with its preview option to check how screensaver will look before applying them. But I didn't found the Android 15 Easter egg screensaver which I seen in the Android 15 Bezel custom ROMs. So these are some of most interesting Android 15 features. Additionally, we get this PHS stable setting for devices of all OEMs where you can customize or enable some custom settings. Finally, we got this new PHS stock OT updated to update your GSI if you get any update through the developers. We reviewed everything about the GSI, now let's check out some major bugs. First and the most disappointing bug in my 9RT is network. It's not available because the GSI didn't able to detect the baseband of the phone. So I didn't got the network available in the GSI, so I can't able to make the calls. But remember, as per the developer, this issue is only noticeable in some devices, not for all. Next, network and the internet option getting force closes as soon as you tries to tap on it. Next, on the OnePlus 9RT fingerprint setup is not available when you tries to set up the fingerprint. But instead, you can use the face unlock, it's working and blazing fast as compared to the fingerprint unlock option. So these are some device specific bugs available for my OnePlus 9RT, but you may or may not face these all issues. We have to test all these things on your device personally. Custom GSI with the DSO sideloader is the easiest way for testing newer Android version, and if you felt it's stable enough to use as a daily driver, then you can use it as a sticky mode to boot this OS as a primary OS on your device. So that's it for today guys, hope you liked my work, then please do like and share this video, subscribe our channel, press the bell icon for the notifications of our upcoming content. Thanks for watching, see you next time, take care, bye bye.